myself SD, and today I'm going to show you how to add multiple IP address in EC2 instance in AWS. So first of all, you have to logged in into your AWS accounts. So this is the dashboard. So I have a running instance. If I click on an instance, I can see that I have two instances. The one is running. So the difference between public IP and the Elastic IP, what is the difference? In AWS, the difference is both are the live IP, because you can check with that. It is accessible in the internet. You can check. But if I stop that instance and start that instance, that IP will change. So that's why we need a Elastic IP. So at first, I go for Elastic IP. And one thing is that you can see that there is no Elastic IP in my server. That no Elastic IP, you can check. So I go to the Elastic IP. Allocate the new IP address. This is one. And this is second IP. Okay. I have two Elastic IP. So I first one, I associate that address with my new server running instance. Okay. So you can check that one is assigned and one is not assigned. So I go to that server. You can check. Now I have a Elastic IP, and also the public IP also change. So you can check that this page is not working anymore. Now that IP are added. Okay, so I have to add another IP. So I go to the network. From the action area, manage IP address, I assigned IP address and yes, update. So you can check that private IP address I already have an assigned. So I have to go again in that Elastic IP. One thing is that now you can check in your instance that have two private IP now. If I select that, you can check that is a private IP and the secondary private IP is .43.81. So I have to assign that one also. Go to the IP and I have to associate that address. If I only select that address and I just click on the associate, so the previous IP will change. It means the first IP is released, so I have to change from there, 43.81, the private IP. Okay. So now we can check from the instance. Wow, we have a two Elastic IP. So if I check with that. Is the page not opening? But here is the page opening always, because this is my default IP now, but this IP not assigned, so I have to assign first. So I go to install the PuTTY. Yeah, so I have to connect with the PuTTY. Copy the Elastic IP. Basically, I have to connect the server, and I have to assign that key. Open my server now. Open. Okay, so I have to go to the root user. Oops, sorry. Now I have to put a command. Then I have to copy that. Okay. Once again, I have to check that the Ethernet network ETH0. It's ETH0. Wow, we have done that work. So now you can check. Yeah, it's working perfectly. So both IP are working. Now your IP have the server have the two IP address. It's so simple and beautiful things in the AWS. So you can add so many IPs in there. So thank you very much for watching my videos. Please like and comment. And also subscribe, because if you subscribe my video, so you know about me and also my latest upcoming video. Thank you so much. Please comment if any queries or any type of video you want. Good night.